Growing up black in Philadelphia in the early 1900s, Marian Anderson understood race prejudice. Her grandfather had been born a slave. A music school rejected her because of her color. In 1939, the Daughters of the American Revolution refused to let her sing in Constitution Hall because Washington, D.C. was still a segregated city. First Lady Eleanor Roosevelt helped Anderson arrange an outdoor concert at the Lincoln Memorial instead. Anderson became a symbol of dignity in the face of unjust persecution. At the height of the civil rights struggle in the 1950s, the Soviet Union and other countries were criticizing the United States for its continuing racial abuses. The U.S. government was sending illustrious and well-educated black citizens abroad to improve America's image. The State Department asked Anderson to represent her country as a goodwill ambassador. Remarkably, Anderson said yes, she would serve. Why did she agree to sing and speak for the country that still denied her rights? Her diary offers us no clues, but CBS TV captured the tour and showed her performance to the American public soon after her return. Anderson told a hopeful story, presenting the United States as a nation overcoming its past. This story was very like the U.S. government's own message about race. But Anderson also spoke personally about the experience of keeping on in the face of adversity.
It is so true that no matter how big a nation is, it is no stronger than its weakest people. And as long as you keep a person down, some part of you has to be down there to hold him down. So it means you cannot soar as you might otherwise. Therefore, regardless of how small the Negro may be in whatever area, the whole of our nation is dependent on what is done for the little fellow, dependent sometimes on his very life. The fact that we were able to come over for the State Department and are thrilled beyond words with the honor and the opportunity gives us, as there certainly must be in the hearts of many Negroes who may not see the light of day, so to speak, an opportunity to speak for the only land that we know. If we were not in America, many of us might still be in Africa. Some of us might be happier, some of us wouldn't be. I know nothing of Africa, I haven't been there, so my land and my country and my allegiance is with America.
When CBS aired its TV special, fan letters poured in from across America. Some viewers confessed their own prejudices, vowing to do better. Some mentioned the religious aspect of her message and called her a saint for forgiving her persecutors. Many letter writers praised her graciousness and her understanding, saying that she had shown Asia the best America had to offer. Anderson's forgiving words and her distinguished performance taught Americans to empathize with her experience and to accept her as their representative. Perhaps Anderson knew that she was also an ambassador to her fellow Americans. I hope she did.